2022 Ramon Magsaysay Awardee, environmental activist Gary Benchabib wants to bring his anti-plastic advocacy to the Philippines. Benchabib's organization, Sungai Watch, is known for collecting and upcycling trash and other items. Andrew Bagawisan has this report.
Ending pollution, one river at a time. Frenchman Gary Benchabib is leading the fight against plastic waste in Indonesia through his NGO, Sungai Watch. They collect around 3,000 kilos of trash in rivers in Bali and Java a day, recycling them into durable items. He is also pushing for an end to single-use plastics in the country.
I think when you see things like this that are so in your face, you know, almost a depressing issue, there are two things you can do, right? You can either walk away and not pay attention to it, thinking that it's somebody else's problem, or you can actually dive deep inside of it and find solutions for it. Rivers are a perfect reflection of our actions on land, and cleaning them up is not going to be the solution. We need to change way before, you know, we are actually dumping plastics in its rivers.
At 27, Benchabib is the youngest of the four recipients of the Ramon Magsaysay Award for this year, Asia's version of the Nobel. He is recognized for using the power of video and social media to push for his environmental advocacy. It's one he began as a 14-year-old organizing beach cleanups in Indonesia with his siblings Kelly and Sam, with whom he co-founded Sungai Watch in 2020. One of Benchabib's crazy ideas, documenting an expedition to Chittagong River in West Java, dubbed the world's most polluted, on a kayak of plastic bottles. This prompted the Indonesian government to take action, announcing a 7-year rehabilitation program of the waterway. Now, Benchabib plans to expand his efforts to the rest of Indonesia and its neighbors, including the Philippines. A 2021 study found the Philippines contributing a third of plastic reaching the world's oceans, with 7 out of 10 contributing rivers within the country. The Pasig River running through Manila identified as the top plastic pollution source. Benchabib plans to see the situation for himself when he comes to Manila at the end of November for the Magsaysay Awards ceremony.
Every single minute, you know, one garbage truck full of plastic pollution enters our ocean, and that, you know, is set to increase. So I think we have to change the entire system, and it needs to be global systematic change. And that's why, you know, potentially projects like ours, but many other projects need to scale throughout the region, throughout Asia. We need to use this opportunity to keep on fighting this fight, because, you know, Indonesia needs it, the Philippines needs it, many other countries need proper solutions.
A fight Benchabib hopes everyone, not just those inspired by his example, will take part in. Andrew Bagawisan, ABS-CBN News.
Nearly 2 weeks since severe tropical storm Paeng battered the Philippines, dozens of villages in the province of Laguna are still flooded. ABS-CBN correspondent Dennis Dato gives us an update. Dennis?
Yes, Denise, 12 days after severe tropical storm Paeng ravaged the country, yet many parts of Laguna remain flooded. According to Laguna Provincial Government Information Officer Chris Sanjit, 89 villages are still submerged in waist deep. These areas are situated near the Laguna Lake from the cities of San Pedro, Binyan, Santa Rosa, and Calamba, and the towns of Bae, Alaminos, Victoria, Rizal, Nagcarlan, Calawan, Pila, Santa Cruz, Lumbaan, Mabitak, Fami, and Paite. Because of this, almost 4,000 families, or at least 15,000 individuals, are still staying in evacuation centers. In Sitio Masagana and Sitio Mapayapa in Barangay Pansol, Calamba City, 65 families are still in the evacuation centers due to the waist deep flood. Village Chairman Joel Martinez said the flood may last up to 2 months, just like what they experienced in 2020. Martinez said the water is slowly subsiding because the Laguna Lake is getting more shallow. The provincial government is continuously providing relief goods to the affected families. Potable water stations were also deployed, and several medical missions have been conducted. The damages caused by Paeng to the province of Laguna amounted to 147.8 million pesos in agriculture sector and 55 million pesos in infrastructures. 7 were reported dead, while 2 are still missing. Denise.
Thanks, Dennis.